Tutorial, I'm going to tell you how to use these Camlin brush pens for fashion illustrations. I have this particular one with 24 brush pens in this following colors, you can see, and I will be putting the links in the description box. So I picked out these three colors which I will be using to render the skin. The color names are not mentioned on the pens, and I randomly picked out the best colors suitable for the skin tones. You can see that these colors are too saturated, I mean they are too loud for the skin. So I will not be using them directly on my skin, but I will use this method of diluting the color first and then adding them to the skin with the brush. So this is a plus point for these brush pens, is that these are water soluble and you can use water to dilute them, and you can also create these skin tones by mixing and matching both the colors or three or more colors according to your preference. So you can see that how I am first putting the color on a palette and then using water to dilute it completely and using that light wash of that color over my skin. So I will talk about the paper, that on which kind of paper this method will work. So right now I am using a classmate drawing copy worth rupees 50, which we get in those stationery shops, so nothing fancy about it. And this method will also work on those art papers, good quality art papers, and I think this will not work very well on ivory sheets, as ivory sheets are good for pencil sketching and blending. So always keep a tissue paper near you so that you can clean your brush in between and avoid picking up more color and damaging your illustration. So work very softly, don't rush with this method, and always use uniform strokes towards one direction. A very important thing regarding this method is that this color settles in very well. I mean, once you are done with the skin, you can't go back and change it using water or any other method. I mean, when we use watercolor, we can go back and change certain things using water as a medium, right? But in this method, once the color settles in, we can't go back and make any more changes. So be very careful while you are picking up your color and using the shade. So it's best when you swatch your color first, and once you're satisfied with the color type, then only use that color on your skin. So guys, I hope you understood this method well, and this can be a good alternative than using watercolor. I mean, if you are confused in using watercolor, you can use these pens directly to dilute them and then using those skin tones over your illustrations. And if you already have these pens with you and this is a new method to you, so you can comment down below that if you have used this technique before or you would like to use this technique, then do share your illustrations with me. I would love to see your works. So your base color is ready for the skin. Now you can add your own detailing however you like. You can either use fineliner pens or pencil colors similar to your skin tones, or a skin color darker than your base skin tone. So however you wish. And I have separate videos for the face series, you can see them. So I will be using this brush pens to draw the hair. There are some brown shades, some gray and some black in the set which you can use to do the hair, and work very carefully. These colors are very saturated and you wouldn't want to mess up everything, so do practice before moving to your main illustration. So I will be sharing a quick review on these pens and its merits and demerits, and whether you should purchase these pens or not, and I will talk about this, so watch the video till the end. So coming back to the illustration, let us now move to drawing the garments, and I will show you certain techniques. The first one, I would be showing you how to use two shades of the pen, that is a darker green and a lighter green along with black, to show the high shine in the fabrics such as silk, satin or velvet. So the first step would be to use the lighter shade of the color all over your garment, and always use a single direction to put your color, and also see the grain line of your garment and use the color in that direction only. So now we will start working on our folds and then use the darker shade to emphasize those folds, and at the last step we will be using the black. So you can see that now I'm using the darker shade of the green to mark the folds and especially at the corners of the garment, and this will emphasize those darker shadows in those kind of fabrics like silk or velvet or satin. So the final step would be to use the black. Now use black very carefully only at the corners or the darker parts of your garment, and to mark certain folds and behind the leg where there will be maximum shadow. So to blend the black color very well, I will be using my earlier green shade, and I will use that to blend the black color. So I will be using a fine liner to define everything and give some borders and some definition to the garment. So to give the look of velvet over this, you can use pencil colors like black, gray or white to give the grainy texture of the velvet fabric. So the next fabric rendering technique I want to show you is how we can draw sequins using a single pen. brush pen and diluting it with water, and how we can increase and decrease the intensity of the color. So water plays a key role in this method. When you put more water to dilute the color, the intensity of the color decreases and you get a very light wash of the color. And if you want to use a very maximum intensity of the color, you can use the water less. So that's how you can use a wide range of the intensity of the single color to make your sequins garment. So now in the final step, you can see I am using the color directly to give the final dark shadows of the sequins, and how I have used the color layer by layer to give the effect of sequins. And at the last step, I would be using some white paint to give those shiny effect. So very quickly, I will be doodling some lace effect for my lace bralette, and with the help of this pen and some pencil medium, I will be completing this bralette look. So guys, if you want me to make more separate videos on certain art supplies like markers or pencils from any particular brand, you can comment below or you can connect me directly over my Instagram, and do mention that which brand or which medium you want me to try out and make a tutorial on that. So the next fabric rendering I would be showing is how to draw a sequins golden skirt using the brush pens directly. So I will be using two shades of the yellow. First is the normal yellow and the second would be the yellow ochre. So use the darker tone of the yellow at the corners and at the fold line, and you can see I have kept the middle portion as white. I mean that would be the area of the extreme shine, so I have left that area blank. So to show the extreme shadows in the sequins, I will be adding the black. Now use the black very carefully. Use it at the extreme corners and some random scribbling here and there and along the fold line. To bring out the sequins look more vibrant, I will be using white paint at last to show the glittery effect. So using a black pencil now, I will add some more depth to the skirt and I will darken the corners and mark the fold lines. to draw the leather boots, I will be using two tones of the brown. First, I will use the lighter shade of the brown, and then I will use the darker shade, and lastly, I will use some black. So I am done with the illustration. Let us quickly move to the review of these brush pens. So the good thing about these pens are that they are very dynamic to use. You can give larger strokes and very fine strokes using the same pen. The next thing is that you can't use these pens like those watercolor pencil mediums where you can use water to dilute it. So you can't do that. After you have given a stroke, you can't use water to dilute it. But what you can do is that you can use the water on a palette and use water to dilute it, and then you can use a paintbrush, the technique which I have shown earlier in this video. Now, talking about the layering and the blending of the color, you can use a darker shade over a lighter shade and you can blend them. But you can't use a lighter shade over a darker shade because that won't show up. So here you can see I have used a lighter shade first, that is yellow, and now I'm using this green over this yellow, and the color which is coming out is something like padded green. And yes, that's how this works. And also how we can create our own skin tones. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video and you liked my tutorial. And yes, don't forget to subscribe the channel. And I will see you in the next one. Till then, take care.